It's the holiday season, and that calls for a review of a holiday-themed game. It's too bad I don't really have any holiday games. Well, maybe that one. But let's check the archives. Ah, the Lost Reindeer. As a 10-year-old kid, any gift that I gave at Christmas time was either homemade or really cheap. I bought this game way back then for my sister from a dollar store. Seriously, from a dollar store, as in it cost $1. I guess we'll find out why I have it now. Now, the strange thing about this game is that even the mighty Google doesn't know it exists. I can't find a single piece of information about it, not even who programmed it. I kind of remember what the cover art looked like, but I can't find that anywhere on an image search. The closest I've come is this little blurb from a Russian site that looks like an eBay ripoff. Also, some Christmas episode of CSI is throwing off my search results. Maybe this game is one of a kind, a priceless artifact of the mid-90s. Maybe it's one big fat Yule log. Now, even though it runs in DOS, and so would run in DOSBox, you have to install it within Windows 3.1. And since I don't have any way to emulate Windows 3.1 right now, it's time to get out the old HP. 8 megs of RAM, 500 megabyte hard drive, 90 megahertz Pentium 1. This is the very machine my family had when I was growing up. I've been dragging it around all these years thinking I'll do something with it. Now today is its time to shine. Maybe someday I'll do a full-on video about this thing, but for now, let's boot this sucker up and play the Lost Reindeer. Alright, the moment of truth. Oh man, even the menu is terrible. Is that even really a reindeer, or did the programmer just take this picture in his backyard or something? I can't even understand this music. I mean, really, it's just like a garbled mess, kind of with an inkling of green sleeves underneath. In fact, I think I've heard this music before. No, really, it's a MIDI ripoff of a Mannheim Steamroller song. So as it turns out, The Lost Reindeer is a pretty straightforward platformer with the goal of getting to the end of each level, obviously. Now you do, however, have to collect all the pieces of candy canes in the level to progress, and it's actually pretty unforgiving. You only have 3 lives, and the lives are carried over from level to level, and it's one-hit kills. The controls suck, but they are manageable, I guess. The level design, though, I just don't know. Okay, so the presents I get, you know, candy canes, sure, it's schlocky, but it's Christmassy. Snow and pine trees, that makes sense. Seahorses? Flying sharks? Black cats? Beehives? You completely lost me. Hey, at least Comet himself warns you about these in the intro screen. Seriously. And whether it's sharks or black cats, you can dispense these enemies with a single wad of snot. What, you didn't know reindeer could projectile sneeze snot wads with deadly force?
Ow!
Did that thing just say, ow?
Ow!
It's like this game was made by one dude who just made all the sound effects himself. Also, what makes these animals so averse to mucus? I mean, Leo doesn't die when I sneeze on him.
Ow!
Sorry, buddy. And these snot wads are pretty amazing. They never lose altitude or speed. If you hit down, for some reason Comet turns around and, like, dances in place, at which point you can fire snot the other way. I swear I'm not making this up. I'm not even sure how many stages are in this thing, but I just couldn't do it anymore. Maybe someday I'll beat it. But until then, there you have it. The Lost Reindeer by, some guy, I guess? It's a dollar store oddity of the 90s. A quick Christmas cash-in that's probably, honestly, never made any cash. I'd be very curious to know if anyone watching this video has ever played this before, or even knows anything about it. Anyway, please let me know in the comments section, and until next time, happy holidays from Dome Candy Games. Because video games are like candy for your dome. Sorry, buddy.